Cologne's Delphi Film Palast has seen its fair share of premieres over the decades. Hans Christoph von Bock is in superb spirits. His latest film is about to play to a capacity crowd. The Colón Ring, Wagner in Buenos Aires, is a 93-minute documentary film. It tracks an extraordinary project staged at the most famous opera house in Latin America, the Teatro Colón in Buenos Aires. Richard Wagner's Ring of the Nibelung takes about 16 hours to perform, normally over 4 evenings. The Teatro Colón version was condensed into a single 7-hour production.
I wanted to provide an insider's view of how a modern opera production evolves, one without any commentary, purely from the perspective of the ensemble.
The project got off to a disastrous start when its German director, Katharina Wagner, great-granddaughter of the composer, made an early exit.
Also auf gut Deutsch, leider müssen wir euch mitteilen, wir können unter den Bedingungen nicht arbeiten.
Just 42 days before the premiere.
It's a bonus for a documentary filmmaker because it adds to the drama and tension. That lack of certainty suddenly opened up new developments. It was great in terms of the film's story.
Argentinian choreographer and opera director Valentina Carrasco stepped into the breach with 33 days to go.
Actually, I would probably propose the direction to change the name of this ring, probably to call it something like the earthquake of the Nibelung or something, because it's quite shaky. But hello. But
my job was to say, keep calm. We keep on shooting and see what happens. Maybe this story of downfall and resurrection will be reflected in what we're now seeing on screen.
DW initiated the documentary film and was responsible editorially.
The most exciting part was doing The Ring as it's never been seen before. That really interested us. And the second thing that we found interesting was the intercultural dialogue, which has always been a key issue for Deutsche Welle.
Classical music has perennially been a DW focus. Large-scale productions like the Beethoven Project or Schumann at Pier 2 yielded award-winning films. The Cologne Ring is to become part of that tradition.
I do believe that we've done ourselves proud when it comes to promoting classical music in Germany and Europe. Today's production, and the one following it now, and their broadcast on Deutsche Welle, are further pieces in that mosaic.
The premiere turned out to be a huge hit, which was a great relief to everyone who took part in it.
Every day for 6 weeks, we sat with the editors 10 hours each day and worked through all the material. And to see it, the way it's been condensed like this on the big screen, is fantastic.
Many of the people featured in the film attended the opening ceremony. For them, the Wagner Marathon continues, such as signing DVDs of the documentary, which they've just seen for the first time.
The film magically catches this balance, the words between difficulty and will and fun.
I thought it was wonderful in the sense that it showed not just all the positive sides, it showed all the background discussions and conflicts that we had, as well as the positive outcome.
Der Film war so ein bisschen.
The film was like reliving our time back then. As the film depicts, we really did spend it as though we were sealed off hermetically. We didn't see anything outside the hotel and the opera house.
The condensed 7-hour version of The Ring of the Nibelung, done in one day at the Teatro Colón in Buenos Aires, was a big success. and the documentary by Deutsche Welle kept the viewers glued to their seats as well, and also ended with standing ovations from the audience.